Here on Tybee, there are days when people can't get to work or can't get to school. Unfortunately, flooding is a routine event that we need to better understand because it's no longer a once every 100 years kinds of issue.
Our data is really helping to this community understand not just where water levels are today, but also think about where water levels are going to be in 20, 30, 50 years. This is something that's in this community's doorstep right now, threatening the lives and livelihoods of every resident in Chatham County. The Smart Sea Level Sensor Project is a project that involves a partnership between Georgia Tech researchers and Chatham County and City of Savannah partners merged to tackle coastal flooding. What we're doing is we're installing real-time internet-equipped sensors across the county to relay data back on the status of water levels across the area, and our joint purpose is to keep people safe during increasing events of flooding across the county.
We've seen a noticeable increase in the number of flood events here in Chatham County and really along the whole Georgia coast. This is happening with a much higher frequency. Also more recently, a number of hurricane named storm events that have affected the community led to evacuations at a much more regular basis.
This is cutting-edge technology that's being applied in real time to our city, and this is going to help inform our decisions and save lives. I mean, it doesn't really get any better than that. So for Georgia Tech to come down here and offer this capability to our city, it's an incredible opportunity and one that I'm looking forward to growing into the future.
There's several components of the water sensor project that are instrumental in decision making when it comes to an emergency response. With having these sensors throughout the community, it allows us to see in real time where the flooding issues are and allows us to be able to make real time decisions as to where resources need to be deployed.
And so you think about the tourism industry, you think about the fishing industry. These are aspects where if you have a degraded environment because of coastal flooding that goes unmanaged, then you're going to have immediate impacts on the lives and livelihoods of residents here.
This project is completely about the partnership with Georgia Tech and the local community at all levels, the cities, the counties. The partnerships that they have brought to the table and the investment that they have brought is critical for the success of this project.
So students are our best asset at Georgia Tech. I mean, we have this crop of amazingly talented students, and they actually are clamoring for real-world experiences. They want to be part of the climate solution.
To see really these world-renowned professionals and academicians really taking interest in what's happening here locally, we're gratified for that. We think it's necessary. Obviously, the better we are able to forecast and understand our environment and how water flows in and around us, the better we are for emergency planning, for ingress and egress out of our community.
It is really around how we engage the community in this work and understanding all this really highly technical data that we're receiving on sea level rise, but translating that into something that's relevant for Savannah's day-to-day residents.
It's basically a tool for making large-scale physical maps of the places we live. And these maps can run up to 16 feet or bigger. The projection on that table guides people as they identify which are the streets, the parks, the waterways, and other elements that make up their neighborhoods that are important to them. This creates just a kind of a rich context for people to have all kinds of discussions about kind of what matters to them and how to make representations of the place they live that accurately represents their experience.
In their classrooms, students can work with the data that we're learning from the sensors, but also actually putting the sensors together, assembling them, working with Jenkins High School here in Savannah, where the students have actually been doing the assembly, and 30 of the ones we have deployed, they were a part of.
Here at Jenkins with the Smart Sea Level Project, after you get your initial assignments done, you get assigned to either soldering or getting the cases ready.
Knowing that they have their hands on a project that could help people in the future is pretty important to them. We're not just doing this for immediate response, we're working on something that could have, you know, future impacts 25, 30, 50 years from now.
The engagement and awareness that they talked about was critical to where we are with Savannah. I really want the citizens to really own this process, to feel like they're a part of it.
This change is going to take quite a bit of time and quite a bit of conversations that have to be made respectfully, with sensitivity to the economic pressures, the cultural drivers, and the capacity needs to be built from the ground up.
Georgia Tech is listening, responding, and coming up with ideas and solutions that the community can then assess, agree with, and implement.
This is the reality that we're living in and the global climate that we have. Sea level is going to continue to rise, and how do we inject that into our urban plan and to our neighborhoods to better inform us and make better decisions in the future?
We are here for the long-term process as well, and everybody needs to know that, and that's how you build lasting partnerships that can be impactful in something as sticky as coastal flooding.